You're listening to the Davey Mac Sports Program on the Riotcast Network, riotcast.com.
True Car, that's right. Hey, listen, when you're ready to buy a car, True Car is changing car buying forever. Yes, True Car helps car buyers get rid of the fear that they might overpay. Every day, True Car users receive negotiation-free guaranteed savings, and True Car users save an average, listen to this, of $3,000, $221, off MSRP, Pepper.
When you're ready to buy a car, just follow these three easy steps.
Okay, let me write it down.
First, download the True Car mobile app.
All right.
Or go to TrueCar.com to find out what others paid for the car you want.
That's step one.
Then register to see upfront pricing information and lock in your savings.
I'm locking in as we speak, like I'm locking in my answer on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. Bam.
Third step is simple. Take your guaranteed savings certificate to the True Car certified dealer for a better, hassle-free car buying experience. Some features not available in all states, Dave.
I'll tell you what, with True Car, you can save time, save money, never overpay. See how much you can save on the car you want? Simply download the True Car mobile app or visit TrueCar.com today. True Car.
It's the Davey Mac Sports Program.
It's the Davey Mac Sports Program.
Bang, bang!
On Riotcast.com.
Boom!
And here's your host, Dave Cactus Jack.
Yeah!
MacDon.
Bang, hey! Bang! She burned me, mommy! She burned me bad! And your baby boy had to go and take on the Undertaker in a Hell in a Cell. It's the Davey Mac Sports Program.
Surprised you knew that one.
Yes, sir. I know my wrestling promos. You threw a Cactus Jack on you? I rebut it, my friend.
Well, Mankind.
My name is Eastside Dave. They call me Davey Mac. They call me the sports master.
Master.
All right. Yeah, they're not high. Also with me to my left, Chris Pepistella.
Thanks. Thanks for the round of applause.
Oh, but it wouldn't take place without extraordinaire engineer, Sean O.B. Us, Roy Schaefer. Roy. That's not all, Pepper. Oh, that ain't all, baby.
There's other special guests.
It's tax season. So our annual, once a year for the past 4 years, our annual visitation from Sean O's tax accountant, Dave Richter, is in the house. And what's weird is Dave is a fantastic guitarist. That's him on guitar, Peppy.
I hear him.
I never saw Norm Peterson play guitar that well. He was an accountant too, don't you forget.
And an alcoholic.
And a painter. An alcoholic, an accountant, and a painter for some
kind of like Pollock.
Yeah. And so Dave Richter's going to be... I always extend an invitation to Dave after he kills it year in and year out. I always say, Dave Richter, why don't you come back? He says... Fuck no, bro.
Wow, thanks for
nothing. He says, I have one time and one time only. during Shano tax season. And now I'm not even sure if he's really even in a tax account because he's wearing an Extreme t-shirt. Yeah. Apparently he's Gary Cherone fan number one since day one over
that's
here.
Me.
So we have Dave Richter into his house. Yeah. Come on. Oh, that's him on guitar, baby. We also have Flutesy with us.
Hi.
Hey, it's Flutesy.
Who may or may not be dating one of the New York Mets.
What?
You heard that right, Mike Piazza?
Is it Kurt?
No, it's Mike Piazza. We don't want to say the actual name, Pepper.
Passed.
Okay.
Not even.
And not only.
Is it Matt Harvey?
Do we have all of those fine folks, but visiting us, because we have an open door policy, which is simply if you email me, if you find my email, and you say, may I come in to Skinny Man Studios, I usually say, sure, what the fuck, why not? It's not my studios if you rob them blind. You're going to, you know, Roy Schaefer will be at $150,000 if you steal the equipment. Not the Dave Man. With us, all the way from Vancouver, Ryan! He just told me, Pepper, while we were outside smoking the cigarettes, drinking the beer, that he just auditioned for the new X-Men film. He's an actor. Did you hear that, Eddie Redmayne? We got Ryan from Vancouver breathing down your fucking British ass.
Sounds like we got the new Wolverines here.
The fucking Oscar to that no-toothed limey is a disgrace that they didn't give it to Beetlejuice. But I don't want to get sidetracked. Video, doing this for the video purposes, the historical things, Eric Z, easy money. So there you go. Everyone's been announced. Everyone's been introduced, shall we say, in a flamboyant way, almost as flamboyant as when the L.A. Lakers, a team that's won 17, 18 NBA titles, team synonymous with, you know, along with the Celtics, synonymous like a New York Yankees type of thing, or a Montreal Canadiens for our Canadian friend.
Or Montreal Expos.
Or Montreal Expos, who never actually won a World Series. But
they had a great logo.
Well, they were on their way in 94 before the strike occurred.
I wish they were still Expos, to be honest.
Listen, they had fucking Pedro. They had John Wetland, who then became a good Yankee closer. Anyway, the Lakers beat the Celtics in overtime.
Yeah, to go up to their record 14-41.
Right. And after an 8-game losing streak, they decided to celebrate like this. They went nuts, and this is fantastic. Kobe Bryant was on Jimmy Kimmel, and Jimmy Kimmel showed Kobe Bryant the actual post-game celebration of the L.A. Lakers, who are, as Pepper said, now just simply 14-41.
They're the Knicks, West Coast.
Yeah, they're awful. Go ahead, Sean. I'll play the video here.
Chips. Something to celebrate. Kimmel showed him video of his Lakers teammates after their 14th win.
I saw a clip today that I feel like I have to show you because I must know what your reaction to this is. So the Lakers had an 8-game losing streak. Uh-huh. They beat the Celtics. Uh-huh. Overtime. Great. This is from after that game.
What? This got interesting. Hey, come back.
You feel me? We back in the building. Yeah. Y'all thought we was gone.
Oh, God. You are gone. You are gone.
Jay Hill doing his thing.
You're a joke.
Nick out there hitting his free throws. You know how he do it. You know, Jay Hill goes to the back like that.
Oh, boy.
Do it. You know what I'm saying?
Can we subtitle this?
Oh, come on, Stop. Roy. Stop. Don't go there. That they were trying to interview poor Jeremy Lin. Now, watch Kobe. They gave up.
What would happen if you were there? Would there be a celebration?
Kobe's not talking.
He's just glaring.
He's as angry as possible. In fact, he's angrier than Chris Pepper Stanley. And that's a lot of anger.
Well, that's fuel.
Yes. That's flat-out hatred right there. So that's a good... Thank you for playing that clip, Sean O. Barrett. Sean O. Right. Round of applause for being on top of it tonight.
And there's a Kobe doc coming out on Showtime this weekend.
So Kobe just glaring into the camera, not amused by his quote-unquote teammates who were celebrating like they just won Game 7 of the NBA Finals.
Do you think they were doing that on purpose?
No, this guy, Nick Young.
Genuine stupidity?
This guy, Nick Young, who plays with the Lakers, it's all about him. And, you know, he's like a Kanye West type of character for the National Basketball Association. The poor announcer, or the sideline reporter, I should say, is trying to talk to Jeremy Lin. He's the one guy you didn't hear on that audio clip.
He didn't say one word.
He didn't say one word. The guy's like, so Jeremy, you're... And in comes Nick Young. Yo, we just took down a sound thing.
We back in the house.
He knows it. And I thought the fucking Midnight Rider was back in the house. From the top of the canyon to the bottom of the sea, across the ocean, we have a unicorn in our thing. Oh, you can't find one more. Hell, banana. And poor Jeremy Lin had to watch this whole fucking thing.
This music?
I don't know. Roy, he doesn't know that song. One more sip of dollar, baby. One more silver dollar. Don't worry about it. We're done. That's the end of the Midnight Rider. But I love the fact that Kobe was real about it. He wasn't laughing. He wasn't, you know,
Kobe ever put up a front to act as if things were okay? I mean, the guy is a genuine dude.
He's
a genuine dick.
It was very Michael Corleone-esque, like-esque, where you could see Kobe saying, you know, making one phone call to Robert Duvall and saying, fucking take these guys out. Before I rejoin the team from my ninth fucking knee surgery, take these motherfuckers out.
I'm starting to feel like he's going to get traded away to another team before the end of his career.
Nah, I don't think so, because the Lakers, very similar to the Yankees last year with Jeter. Basically, Kobe is the only one who fills that arena and who gets some good ratings. I mean, this is proven. When Kobe's on the team still gets good TV ratings in the LA market, so you're going to keep Kobe around the same way the Yankees kept Jeter. And the Yankees knew last year they were going nowhere.
But look at the Knicks. I mean, it's a bum squad. It's been a bum squad
for years.
They
don't have that type of player. Carmelo's not Kobe.
Yeah, I know, but no. But I'm saying they still sell out every night. The Knicks are still sold.
Knicks, I mean, A, have arguably a better fan base, but B, keep one thing in mind. Madison Square Garden is in downtown or midtown Manhattan. You have all these stockbrokers.
Right,
so it's not just Knicks fans.
Wait, that's not downtown Manhattan.
Midtown. Midtown. So plenty of people give, you know, the fucking seats away. The companies own, you know, 50 seats for every single game. And so they're able to say we have a sold-out arena. Doesn't mean that the place is packed. Doesn't mean that every single person's in attendance. It just means that it's sold out, quote-unquote.
Yeah, like that WCW, WCW pay-per-view from years ago.
Do you see what I'm talking about? No. Bang, bang!
No, classic reference.
Boom! It's all about ECW, WCW, and WWE tonight, Sean O'Barry.
Yeah, I love
you
it.
Like
it's
that?
It's our wrestling
I love
show.
Letters, yeah.
And Dave Richter, how are you? Does Sean cheat on his taxes, or do you do that for him?
No, he is fine. He is
He's
above
okay?
the line, ahead of... No.
Because I saw the form you were filling out, and Sean O'Barry listed 13 dependents in his Long Island household.
I counted them all. Yes, they are all there.
Okay. He listed Roy's family as
Yeah, there's some fucking sense. Dirty business going on.
I got two fish.
He said he was.
Feed themselves, you know what
I'm saying? He was also married to Eileen Schaefer, Roy's wonderful Irish bride.
I noticed that.
I know her real name, Roy. I just didn't want you to give it out on the air.
Good day.
Unless you want me to.
No, it's cool.
I can do a Goodfellas reference with that. Trust me, any day of the week I can. What'd you do? What'd you do, Karen?
We needed that.
Karen, oh my God, what'd you do?
We needed that money. That was all we got, Karen.
Stupid bitch.
I flushed the cocaine down the toilet, Roy. I didn't want you to get popped by the FEDs, the FBI, and the ATF. Well, when we were in Dublin, Roy, we didn't do the amount of cocaine that you and Henry and Jimmy and
you guys
Tommy did.
Coke.
That was all the money we had, Karen.
Oh,
why
God.
Did you do that?
Things got so good, I even brought in Tommy and Jimmy. And I like when Joe Pesci goes, how's this look? He goes, looks fucking beautiful. That's how it looks. But it's
shoebox.
It's off camera when he says that. You gotta really listen to the part there. He goes, how do you think this looks? It looks fucking beautiful. That's how that looks. Kobe. Oh, breaking news, and we talk about him all the time. Old Graham Cracker Bones, Derrick Rose, is out again.
Done. What
torn meniscus again. The same torn meniscus in his right knee. That's been giving him problems since 2012 and 13. And he was sidelined all last year. Everyone
Look,
wanted
let's
to come
just
back.
Say the MVP year was a fluke.
He's gone. He's gone. He's done. That's a Gale Sayers.
He's gone.
Check him in the fucking book there. Gale Sayers' ass. You will never see Derrick Rose as a prominent ball player. He might have a Penny Hardaway type of career where he's 34 and you're like, wait, Penny Hardaway's still playing in the NBA, you know?
Yeah, I mean...
But he might have that type of career. He's not having the Derrick Rose that we thought he was going to have at Memphis. And then, yes, when he won MVP in the NBA in 2011. Sad. Really, Pepe.
Sure.
His meniscus is weaker than your liver. True or false?
True.
Oh!
Wow.
That means you're dead. That means you're going to die very soon, Derrick Rose. If your fucking meniscus is worse than Pepe's liver... You shit out of luck, dogs.
What?
Hey, did you hear Dan DeVito? This made me think of you for some reason.
Why?
Dan DeVito was in Rolling Stone, and he's 70 years young, and they go, they say to him, hey, Dan DeVito, if there was like a line of coke, I don't even know how this came up in the Q&A session.
Do you still do drugs? Or?
They go, would you still do drugs at your age? And he's like, if I saw a line of coke, shit, yeah. He goes, it's a beautiful thing. He even goes, I would hit that bump. He said I would hit that bump.
That's awesome.
He goes, it's a beautiful thing. He goes, and if you had some acid, too. The guy didn't even ask him about acid. He's like, yeah, throw an acid on top of it, baby. I'm like, that's how they fucking killed that couple in Dead Man Walking. Acid and coke. That's not a mix you want to do, right, Peppy? Am I right about that one?
No, I mean, you could do some coke. While
and acid?
Surfing. I mean, you can't do a lot of coke.
Is that candy?
Sounds like very Dead Man Walking-ish to me. Like, you're going to murder a young couple in the woods. Huh? I don't think you want to combine that. I mean, I did plenty of acid.
Yeah.
Wasn't never big into the coke. I may or may not have sampled it once my senior year in high school, and then for some reason attended my high school's soccer match against the rival. And I almost stormed out onto the field. Yeah. I was trying to climb the fence because I thought the referee made a bad call. And I went to an all-Catholic Dead Poets Society type school. And it was run by brothers who were the male equivalent
Black
of
guys?
Nuns. No!
I thought you were being racist.
Brothers, like Brother Michael, Brother Andrew, Brother Kevin.
Black guys.
And I tried to climb the fence. And Brother Mike, who was 6'5", 400 pounds, brings me back. And he goes, McDonald. You're going to have to leave the game now. You're not in your right mind.
McDonald, you're way whacked out on coke.
He just
right
thought
now.
I was boozed up. He thought I was boozed up. He wasn't thinking that, you know. He didn't know that I was into the Danny DeVito
disease.
You were
banging rails left and right.
I wasn't saying that.
Well, good for Danny DeVito.
Yeah,
at
70
least
years
being
young.
Honest, he's like, all right, yeah, sure. If there's a bump, yeah, I'll do a bump.
I know.
Sure.
I like that. I mean, and also it fit. It's a Rolling Stone article, which, you know, they had their little drug pass, and Hunter Thompson was a writer. I'm not sure if The View asked him that, although he was on The View screaming about limoncellos with George Clooney 5 years ago.
Excuse me, Danny, would you ever pop a Molly if it
sure
came?
Sure! Why the fuck not?
How about Special K? Would you like to?
Yeah, fuck it all!
Like
give me horse tranquilizer, shoot right into my dick hole!
We have some Quaaludes or vintage.
Go! Fuck it, I'm gonna get off the rails, baby! By the way, Ryan from Vancouver told me off the air, is this true, Ryan?
Yeah.
He was a Devils fan his entire life.
Yeah, true.
Go ahead, say that to the microphone.
Devils fan my entire life, David.
There you go!
Like, why?
To confirm it!
Okay. No.
Because he has a very strange accent that's not, it sounds like half Canadian, but half Mick to me.
Yeah. Is this true? Are you
totally from Canada, or were you from any parts in Ireland?
I'm like a third generation Canadian, but if you go back far enough, it's probably nothing but Irish.
There you go. I actually thought it was Sean O'Barry's brother.
It does kind of look like Sean.
I go, Hank Barry in the house. And Sean O says, A,
up,
my brother's
Hank?
Name isn't Hank.
Yes,
it's James.
It don't lie, it's Hank.
And B, you've met my brother 9 times.
Actually, probably like once.
I met his brother once outside.
Yeah, I met him more than that. More than that, right?
No.
I met him once outside Belmont Racetrack as I was leaving. He just rolled up in his car.
Yo, Peppa!
That's literally what happened.
Oh, that happens all the time, man. You're always surprised when someone like actually recognizes you from this bullshit.
My brother told me about that. He's like, I think I saw Pepper at Belmont. I'm like, oh, you did.
I usually anticipate when someone screams like, yo, Pepper, or yo, Eastside Dave, that what's going to follow next is like a can of mace shot right to my eyeballs.
Like,
I can't
shot.
Believe, like, wait, you're actually like a fan or a listener of this fucking nonsense? In fact, because he's here, because this man's here, we're going to play one of Canada's great artists. Austin, Canada's great artist. His name is Ray the Canadian Wiley Hubbard. And he's an incredible Canadian / Austin.
Are you sure about that?
Well, I don't know exactly where he's from.
Correct.
I don't know where he's from.
I think he's from Quebec City.
But I thought we'd do a musical homage to Canada. Our friends of the North. They've been so good to us all these years.
Love Canada.
We go in there. You get better strip clubs. You
Montreal's
know?
Wonderful.
I mean, no offense to Centerfolds in Neptune, New Jersey on Route 35, but you know what? You're a little fucking pricey sometimes. I mean, if Dave Mac wants a fucking handy, he shouldn't be having to pay $75 on top of the $20 lap dance. 30? I'll negotiate. I'll give you 30.
You ain't getting that handy, bro.
Not like Canada. They'll fucking give you anal for an extra $5.
When you cross the border, you get a hand job.
That's right. And those Canadians still have Queen Elizabeth on their money. Isn't that weird?
On the back of the $5 bill or whatever, there's kids playing hockey.
Yeah, no. It's Gretzky. I got a woman who's wild as Rome. She likes being naked and gazed upon. She crosses a bridge, sets it on fire. She lands like a bird on a telephone wire. I'm gonna holler, I'm gonna scream. Gonna give me some mescaline. Then I'm gonna rhyme that with gasoline. It's
drunken poet's dream. Whoa, there's some money on the table and a pistol on the floor. A few paperback books by Louis L'Amour. Whiskey bottles are scattered like last night's clothes, with cigarettes, papers, and Oreos. I'm gonna holler, I'm gonna scream, gonna give me some mescaline. Then I'm gonna rhyme that with gasoline. It's junkie poet's dream. Whoa! Take it away, Dave Richter, Charnot's tax man.
Come on, baby.
Woo! Yeah, baby. Baby,
come out.
Do it for me, baby.
And yo.
Bruce Dickinson, baby. The cock of the walk, baby. Yeah. Shaver, take it away. That was me on harmonica, by the way.
No.
Yeah, it was.
I couldn't tell.
Take it away, baby, Rook. Yes, Rook.
Yeah. Get some.
Roy Shaver.
Get some.
That's keyboard.
Shaver doing it.
That's tickling the ivory, baby. All right, here we go. Now back that, into it.
It's not technically ivory.
I'll never pay back my student loan. Smell it like cord, cheap cologne. She tells me not to worry about judgment day. She says, dying, get to heaven, go to hell my way. I'm gonna holler, I'm gonna scream, gonna give it some mescaline. Then I get a rhyme that with gasoline. Drunken poet's dream. Whoa. I got a woman who's wild as Rome. She likes being naked, gazed upon. Yeah, baby! Bruce Dickinson, baby! Rock it along, baby! Yeah. Ray Wiley Hubbard. Drunken Poet's Dream by Ray Wiley Hubbard. That's one of the great songs of all time ever performed on the Davey Mac Sports Program.
Oh, God,
isn't it?
Yes, yes.
I mean, is it better than all of the Doors covers that we've done from time to time?
Almost.
You know? Well, the one song that we know really by the Doors. Five and... No, we can't do it every time. We can't do it every time, Roy Schaefer. Although I'd like to. I like screaming about the little blue man in the little blue hat trying to push me around.
Yeah, we know.
I like that part. That's my favorite part of the song, actually.
I know this.
You know what I mean, Peppy Ham?
I'm getting you.
You know what I'm saying, Peppy Hamburgers?
I got you, buddy.
Hamburger Peppy.
Remember
that's
bang,
reversible
bang?
Order right there. Boom, boom. So anyway.
That's the wrong one, you say.
Marshawn Lynch, right?
That's not it, yeah.
He's trademarked the phrase, I'm just here so I don't get fined, close quote. But he also made a movie about himself.
I saw this. Just a trailer.
Yeah.
To show to prospective Hollywood people.
Yeah, it's called Family First. The Marshawn Lynch story. It stars his little brother Devontae as Marshawn Lynch in high school.
Smart. Ice Cube's kid's playing him in the NWA biopic.
Right, but then when Marshawn gets to college, he actually takes over, even though he's a 30-year-old man who looks about 59.
It's like Rodney Dangerfield.
When you're watching this thing, and
back to school, right?
And it gets to the college part, and he starts playing himself. It looks like a porno.
Oh, it's awesome.
I'm pretty sure
I did see it as Marshawn Lynch's casting couch on Uges.com. Play us a minute, or try play us the opening sequence, and then we'll just fast forward to Marshawn Lynch because some of it's too long. Although I like the one white coach on the sideline who's yelling about, what kind of coverage are we in?
Yeah, it's great. It's great acting.
Probably the worst acted film I've ever seen. All right, here we go.
Well, it's just not film yet.
Can you tilt that screen?
Towards up
down
this way.
Now you there know you got lucky today.
Those two touchdowns wasn't no luck, punk.
Young Marshawn.
They really care about their sound, too, because this sounds really authentic. It's like eight people in the crowd.
Well, it's high school. It was like you was in a zone.
A what?
A zone. Was it like your body and your
He hadn't
mind
heard of the zone?
While
no.
Your body
that's
over?
Been like a phrase for 30 years.
He's from Oakland. They don't get it.
They don't get the zone?
These boys out of trouble and in
now we're talking about like it's
you
kind
know,
of got like
one of them victories. Yard for yard.
It's like boys in the hood.
What? Who's this?
And it's just like that in life, gentlemen.
And it's all rip off of Pacino. It's them inch for inch, yard for yard.
Say it. I'm going to see you back up with crime.
You are, nigga. Show
hey, 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 hey.
I'm going to show you.
We don't need that. Right, here's the white coach part.
Got our hands full. God damn it. Foot covers your ears. Face down, four dogs.
All right.
God
all right.
Damn it, Dave.
I know.
Covers your ears.
Pause it for a second, Sean LB. That sounded like when the Def Comedy Jam comedians used to do white people impressions.
God yeah. Damn it.
Like, that sounded like a, that looked
gosh,
like a white guy doing a white guy impersonation from the 90s.
That's how he was
God
directed.
God damn it. What kind of coverage are we in, man?
I'm such a square.
Yeah.
Duh.
Like, well, what are you, trying out for fucking Fargo? Ryan from Vancouver. Was that well acted? You're an actor, for Christ's sake.
Not in the least.
Not in the least, Roy. Sting that. Not in the least.
It's rough.
Ryan could take a fucking flip cam and make a better Marshawn Lynch opus than that. And by the way, I would name the movie Skittles, not the Marshawn Lynch story.
No, you can't do that.
Why?
Why isn't there a movie called Jack Daniels then?
Well, Skittles are spelled with two T's, right? So I call it Skittles with two D's.
Oh,
fucking
Skittles.
Skittles. Like, Skittles. Sue my ass, Skittles. Sue it.
That's your new rapper name.
Skittles.
My name is Max Skittles, baby. So I'm really okay. Can we see some Marshawn? Go to like 3 minutes, because right. I can't sit here for this.
He'll
whole
be like
time.
In a locker room.
Interminable trailer they put together. Again, this is the promo for Family First, the Marshawn Lynch story.
And he's shopping this around to try to get someone to actually option the entire film.
Yeah.
Here
you go.
Right there.
Yeah, I see him.
Go pick them up and take them down to the washing machine.
Now, if you could share with us, what is it that made you decide to start your foundation?
Hey, aren't you Marshawn Lynch?
You gotta tell me something. You a reporter?
No.
Are you a reporter?
Yep.
All right, what's up? What you got for me?
When they make a touchdown, they throw candy at you.
I wanna get a new grill too.
Oh yeah, let me see. Oh yeah, you could use one.
See? And you see why I'm so charming.
All right, enough. Pepper's right.
I can't wait for this.
I feel
this.
Like we're watching.
It's softcore pornography.
It looks like when you go to UJ's and you put in BBC. You know what I'm saying, baby?
They got to bring the audio
am
here.
Am I the only one who puts
terrible.
In BBC
we'll fix that.
Habitually? Let's just, for political purposes, say
this room.
Big African-American cock, BBC. Okay?
So.
I don't know. Those aren't even the letters.
Careful, Dave.
Well, the actual letter is B, Sean. BBC, Sean. Okay. BBC, you guys are huge into that in Canada,
CBC.
Right?
CBC. Yeah.
No, no, it's BBC.
They have the CBC,
they have
too.
All the British shit the over there.
Do you like Trailer Park Boys?
Yeah.
That's right.
Go ahead, no, go on the record.
Do you like Trailer Park Boys, yes or no, please?
I do, David, yes.
He loves it!
Oh! Next question.
Sting it! Sting it, he loves it! And he called me David, which I like.
Do you like
He
Degrassi?
Called me by my Christian name. I always find that to be very classy. You know? Do you like Kids in the Hall? I used to love those fucking guys.
Oh, yeah.
Right? Absolutely, David.
How about Degrassi? Degrassi, Next Generation.
Yeah, Wheels, Snake.
Oh, hell yeah. All right. See?
What about
all
you?
Right?
What about you can't do that on television?
Sean,
what
please.
What the fuck,
man? Pepper and I were like, we look good with Canadian culture
we're
right now.
Canada.
And now we're not going to talk about Moose and Alistair and the rest of those fucking schmizbos.
Thank you.
From that child's version of Saturday Night Live. God damn it, Sean LB.
Ruined.
I wish your brother Hank Barry was here now.
Sorry, Ryan.
He was so good.
He would fucking tell
you
a thing or two.
You were so good. Actually, Sean O has a great story about the Red Hot Chili Peppers. Sean O Barry, you take it away now.
Yeah, I got an email from my friend Nelson. The subject is the Red Hot Chili Peppers. I get very excited. All of a sudden, in the email, he says...
And that's one of your favorite bands. Everyone knows
this,
right?
My favorite band of all time.
Okay, okay.
And in the email, it says, hey, they're playing B.B. King's. Here's a link to get tickets. I click the link, quickly try to get the tickets. I'm logging in. Oh, man, here's a VIP. We can try to get the VIPs.
VIP.
Oh, they're all sold out.
Oh, no.
Oh shit, they're sold,
no.
out.
Sold out.
Let me get your admission. Hurry, get it. Okay, I got it. I got two
he
tickets.
He got it.
Two tickets, your admission.
Yeah,
only 30 bucks each.
Yeah,
he's in, right, Peppa?
Boom. Yeah. Get the confirmation.
This Sunday, right?
What? No, March 1st.
That's this Sunday, baby.
This Sunday, then.
That's right. Get
so,
it right.
Get the confirmation email. What does it say? Yeah. You have tickets to go see the Red Hot Chili Pipers. I bought
it's a
tickets.
Fucking bagpipe band covering Red Hot Chili Pepper songs.
You're going, right? Fuck yeah, I'm going.
Actually, I'm like, that would be the one time I did see the Red Hot Chili Peppers. Is I would actually go see the Red Hot Chili Pipers, then I'd finally be into their music. Because I've never been a big chili pepper guy. But the Chili Pipers? That's got Davey Mac all over it.
They're used.
I know, Sean O'Barry, come on. Invitation here for the Dave Man?
We'll see. If the wife doesn't want to go, we'll see. Roy's got first dibs, though.
If she doesn't want to go.
The wife doesn't want to go. All right. Give it away, give it away, give it away now. Give it away, give it away. What you got to give it to your mother. What you got to give it to your father. What you got to do? Billy Connolly, everyone's favorite Scottish actor. Bang, bang. I don't ever want to feel like I did this day. Take it to the place I love. Take me on the way. Bang, bang. Billy Connolly with the Red Hot Chili Pipers.
Suck my kiss, Billy Connolly.
Suck my kiss. Yeah. Is that Suck My Kiss?
Yeah.
How's that go again?
Could've been, would've been dead, but I didn't get the message.
This is the fucking fruitiest moment in the history of this program.
He jumped right in.
Yeah, you know what? I do prefer the Red Hot Chili Pipers over the Chili Peppers. You just confirmed it when he sang it for real. I liked their one Stevie Ray Wonder song. The blind guy from Texas who went down the plane crash. Stevie Ray Wonder. Yeah, that's it. People, bang bang, don't beat Colby. Yay, wear your kilt, bang bang, and the boot dogs I hate, bang bang, and go, yeah, into Glasgow, in the higher ground.
Sorry, it works.
In the higher ground.
Stroke.
Hey, the glad got deeper than the fire. I know he got at the fire. On you go, when it's good. I look on the moon and bang. Rowdy, rowdy piper is in the red hot chili piper crowd. Yeah, meet my donkey. Say hello, donkey. That was very good. Very good. Roy Schaefer on the bagpipes. Dave impromptu Richter. Bagpipes. Dave Richter on guitar. So that's hysterical, though. The Red Hot Chili Pipers. I'm not even joking. I would see that in a heartbeat.
I was so mad for a second, and I was like, you know what?
This is going to be great.
This is going to be really cool.
This is
going to
be fucking awesome. You've probably seen the Chili Peppers before, right?
Yeah, I've seen like a dozen times.
So why not take a stroll of Chili Pipers?
All right. I'm doing it.
I like it.
Yeah.
Then maybe they could play a little Floyd, Chili Pipers at the Gates of Dawn, and cover Pink Floyd's first album ever with this, during the Syd Barrett years.
I'll mention that to the band.
Please do. Please go up drunkenly on the stage.
Yeah. Knock them down and take the bagpipes and say, this is changing.
And say, like, this is going to be like a Dimebag Darrell situation.
Bang, bang. Shall I yell bang, bang?
Bang, bang.
Yeah. And you're going to have to sneak a gun in.
Well, yes. You're going to definitely have a need to have a piece. I would suggest having Easy Money to video document your last days on Earth.
This would be huge for us.
Your last few moments on the planet Earth.
Yeah, and then
before you get shot by the cops.
Yeah, then we put this video in front of it.
Oh, we'll kill it, man. We're looking for YouTube hits, baby. Right.
I'll do what I can.
Anyway, we can get the YouTube hits up.
You gotta get that sweet YouTube money.
Yeah, come on. I never monetize my shit. Fuck that.
Yeah, why would you want to do that?
Some sort of dirty laundry ring that YouTube's got going.
Really? People making millions of dollars?
No, I monetized the Tom Brady video and still have yet to see a penny from that. What? And we had over 100,000 views on that video.
I got it a million or more. Otherwise, they don't give a shit.
Oh, well, now they tell me. I know. I ain't playing ball, YouTube, okay? We keep our shit non-commercial free, baby. Which actually, I think
lots of commercials.
Yeah, non-commercial free would be lots of commercials.
Mm.
So I didn't really know how to talk that well, YouTube, but I'm going to fuck you in the ass, baby. Don't fuck with me, man. I know Danny DeVito. Me and him will fuck you up, baby. We'll do a couple bumps.
More than a couple.
Right, Pep?
More than a couple.
Are you in if Danny and I want to party? Yeah. Some Friday night?
Yeah, I'm going to turn that down.
Danny's from Monmouth County, New Jersey, just like the Dave man.
I know, you should hit him up.
And both of us do bumps and then go to high school soccer matches.
I definitely do that.
How about this Keith Olbermann? He got suspended because...
For yelling at the Penn State idiots and attacking them on grammar.
Well, someone tweeted at Keith Olbermann, who was very much against the Jerry Sandusky. Oh, he's against child rape.
And he's against Jeter.
Hey, you know, I mean, that's the one time where Keith Olbermann in this show defer is on that child rape issue, you know? Because let's look, take a look around the room. I mean, Ryan didn't realize how creepy we were in person, but he's probably calculating in his head. One of those four people probably has an issue. That's all we'll say.
Oh, multiple issues.
Check their hard drives is what Ryan's writing back to his Canadian
Ryan,
friends.
Don't
check
you
their
say that.
Computers.
Don't you tell Canada that.
So, whatchamacallit? Keith Olbermann, someone tweeted at him from Penn State. We are expecting, you know, Penn State and a link to the fact that the Penn State people had raised $13 million for pediatric cancer.
Yeah.
Olbermann didn't bother to click on the link when they wrote we are. So when they wrote we are, he retorted back, pitiful. Not realizing it was a link against child cancer. So now he's pro kids getting cancer?
Yeah, and then,
is that what we're led to believe?
And then he kept fighting with people. Like
right.
He just kept going and going and going.
When you don't click on the link, Keith, and then you realize, oh shit, I fucking just delete the tweet and then say, whoopsie,
well, Keith,
my mistake.
Keith probably thought it was a link to child porn. He was probably
I told
like,
you. I know, you're right. I told you about Keith. I haven't watched his show ever since that insane Jeter manifesto where he wanted to be a shock jock
well,
and
yeah,
say that Derek Jeter isn't that good, even
he was
though
trolling.
He's the career average is 312 and he's sixth on the all-time hits list. Sixth. I have like millions of baseball players since 1900.
Overrated.
He's sixth.
Well,
not to even mention his fucking postseason attributes. Yeah. Forget about the fact that he hit 350 in the World Series lifetime. Forget all the incredible clutch plays, the flip play, and this and that. Forget all that
3,000 hits was
the
a game
winning home run, a World Series, a walk off home run against the Diamondbacks in 2001. Forget it all.
Ends his career.
He sucks, according to Keith Olbermann.
RBI.
And you know what? Remember, Pepper, I said that finally Keith Olbermann has found his spot. He went to ESPN2. He was able to do the soapbox thing, but he kept it in his wheelhouse of sports. I was into the show, but the Jeter thing ruined Keith Olbermann for me. So now, you know what? Fine. Take your suspension.
I'm not sure if I ever liked Keith Olbermann the first
time. I liked him.
I
liked
know.
Him when he went back to ESPN2 and was doing his shit. But the fucking Jeter thing was such an obvious shock jock. I need ratings and I'm going to
disagree. Yeah, he was trolling.
Disagree.
He was like, all right, well, I'm going to say this.
Everyone's
going to get
pissed
off. It was
such an obvious troll, though.
And then everyone's going to pass it around on the internet tomorrow.
Well, it worked because now no one's paying attention to your show. Because when you take a fucking shitty stance like that, then it so perturbs everyone. Or just it's such a turnoff because it's so obvious. You're either out to lunch or you're shock jocking and trolling. So you know what? There's no reason to tune you in ever. We'll never listen to you when you're on your soapbox because the Jeter thing. You have no more credibility is what it's called.
Where was he before ESPN?
Credibility.
What, current
MSNBC.
TV? Oh, and then before that, he was at Current TV.
He was?
That weird Al Gore channel.
Oh, yeah. He might have went
Which
to Current
Al Jazeera,
after
America.
MSNBC. Yeah,
and then before that, he was, what, CNN or MSNBC? I don't know.
No, he's a Sports Center guy.
Yeah, sports.
Then he went to Fox Sports for a second. Then he went to MSNBC, which everyone was like, what the hell? But he did a good job at MSNBC. And then when, you know, the scandal of, you know, lean forward and he was leaning backwards in his chair if to imply, like, Keith Olbermann won't go with the flow. Keith Olbermann won't roll with the punches at MSNBC. That
Olbermann won't roll with the punches anywhere. He just wants to get fired.
I guess
constantly.
So. He's like the Davey Mac of fucking TV personalities. Just fire his ass, baby. Come on, baby. Bruce Dickinson.
I got some stability. Let me ruin it.
So he finally has his job at ESPN, but now between the Jeter thing and being suspended, I don't know if his days are numbered over there. I don't know where you can go next, Keith. I mean, you could always come here, I suppose. Does Keith know how to play a musical instrument, though? Because let's be honest, you have to know how to play something.
I think he plays the oboe.
Well, if Olby plays the oboe, then come on, Keith Olby. Keith Oboman, right, Peppa?
Got it.
Shut.
Got it.
Yeah. I go Keith Oboman.
Hello, because he plays the
Shut up, baby. I go Keith Oboman, baby. Shut up, baby. Albert Pujols. You got it. Base Keith Oboman or Albert Pujols? He likes Albert Pujols better than Keith Oboman.
Everyone likes.
Okay, Pujols. Pujols. It is almost baseball season, so we can't get away. Now, what's how going on, speaking of Pujols and the Angels, what's happening with Josh Hamilton?
He was called in, we're recording this Tuesday night.
New commissioner, by the way.
No, it's Wednesday night. I have my days mixed up.
Yeah, Bud Selig, by the way, is gone. He just kind of like went away in the middle of the night, and you've got this new Manfred character, Commissioner Manfred.
That was Selig's boy, too.
Of MLB, yeah. He's the longtime Selig henchman.
So Josh Hamilton's been called in for disciplinary action.
So it's Manfred's first thing on the job, huh?
And no one knows what it's for yet.
Oh, come on. Toot, toot, toot.
You think
goodbye.
He's back on that stem?
He's a fucking Dan DeVito. He's hitting those bumps.
It's got to be something drug-related. I mean, the guy has problems.
Of course it is. It's not PED. The one thing about Josh Hamilton is he never uses PEDs. He uses PHDs, performance-hampering drugs, left and right.
Ah.
He hits the fucking needle. He hits the crack pipe, Sean LB.
Yeah.
I mean, he doesn't fuck around.
Maybe smoking some rock before he played baseball might not be the worst thing.
I mean, crack, though.
Baseball, you know, it's slow moving.
Do we really need to be hitting crack, Josh Hamilton? I mean, come on,
you know,
man.
It gets your brain faster, you know?
Gets that home run.
Pepper, just have that one song.
Get that crack
for
smoke.
Ryan from Vancouver. Oh. We've got two songs. Why?
It's a two for Wednesday?
It's a two for Tuesday, baby. Wednesday. Because he, whatever day it is. I'm drunk because he said he was a Devils fan. We're going to play one of the great Devils defensive linemen who wrote this song. His name is Bob Scott Stevens Dylan.
Really?
And he's, yeah, oh yeah. This is a tremendous artist. Pepper, see if this is familiar, okay?
Let me listen to it.
Say affirmative, David.
No, I'm not going to fucking say affirmative.
Ryan was calling me David. How come you never do that?
I think it's weird.
You must leave now. Take what you need. You think will last.
A devil.
But whatever you wish to keep, you better grab it fast. He understands you're open with his gun. Crying like a fire. Look out, the saints are coming through, and it's all over now, baby blue. Yeah, devil wrote this. The highway is for gamblers, better use your sense. Take what you have gathered from coincidence. Your lover who just walked out the door has taken all his blankets from the floor. The carpet too is moving under you, and it's all over now, baby blue. Take it away, boys. Instrumental. Yeah, the Devils won 3 Stanley Cups.
I remember they played this song.
And they would come out each and every game, like,
ladies and gentlemen, your Stanley Cup champion, New Jersey Devils!
Everyone would be like, yeah, Scott Stevens would be like, yeah, fuck you!
It's all over now, baby blue, yeah!
You got my man, the goalie. Who is the goalie again? Martin Brodeur, he only has more fucking wins and more shutouts than any other goddamn goalie in NHL history. Marty Brodeur, everybody!
Did he co-write this?
Woo! Oh, yeah, he fucking was all over this shit.
Stop it. Stop the harmonica. That's it.
Your stepping stones behind, something calls for you. Forget the dead you've left, they will not follow you. The vagabond who's rapping at your door is standing in the clothes that you once wore. Strike another match, go start anew.
All right.
And it's all over. Bob Dylan, baby.
Yeah.
Come on.
Bang, bang.
Cock and a walk, baby.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
You can see someone's just been watching the 40th anniversary of Saturday Night Live on rerun in his house over and over again. Can't get away from it. I love that special. I love Bill Murray doing the Jaws theme.
Oh, Jaws!
It was so great. But Eddie Murphy would not do the cause. Why would you not do the cause, man? Come on, you're a comedian. It's a episode of humor.
Black solidarity.
Oh, stop it,
you. Is that racist to say?
If you're supposed to. It was just a joke. It's just like a fucking joke.
It was very weird when he came out and just threw it to break.
Yeah. Like
well, they said he was going to be in the Celebrity Jeopardy as the cause, and instead they gave it to that other kid, the Kenyon. What's his name? Kenyon Thompson.
Kenya Thompson.
Kenya Thompson?
Name,
yeah. Whatever no, his no. fucking name is. What is his name?
Kenan Thompson.
Kenan Thompson. I was saying it right. Was I not
you
saying
were
saying
it right? Kenyon Thompson.
I didn't mean to say it. I thought that was his name.
Racist.
I didn't look at the fucking scorecard. I didn't look at the scorecard that accurately.
You know you love Good Burger just as much as I do.
Oh, I love Good Burger. He was in that. Shit, I'm going to go on a Kenan Ivory Thompson fucking thing.
Right? Jack Session? Is that what you mean?
That's right. Now, what else is going on? So speaking of that, during February, which is, of course, Black History Month, the Eagles have their calendar, and they gave it to Riley Cooper,
Amazing. The
white wide receiver who before last year at a country music festival said he was going to beat up every N-word that got close to him. This is the guy who has some race issues.
I think he's over him, though.
And they give Black History Month to Riley fucking Cooper. This is why you cannot allow the 21-year-old fucking intern do your social media, be in charge of your calendar. Everyone thinks we need a young person doing this shit. I guarantee you that was someone under the age of 30, some brainless fucking idiot who decided to give Riley Cooper the goddamn Black History Month thing on the calendar.
If I was their calendar operator, he would have been every month.
Oh, come on.
What?
You don't like racism, Pepper.
I do like wide receivers, though.
I know you. Now, anti-Semitism you might like.
Never.
But racism, you don't like. I know you.
I know you.
You're friends with Bronx Johnny.
He's Ecuadorian.
I feel like Marshawn Lynch probably is stealing Bronx Johnny's act a little bit.
You think?
Especially after this porno that Marshawn Lynch is putting together for Hollywood.
It's definitely a porno, right?
You know? Yeah, this weird fucking... Yeah, what's up?
It's for realitykings.com.
That fucking weird shit with the kid and the... Are you a reporter?
No.
And the kid, no? Okay, what you got for me? What the fuck? What are you talking about? What you got for me? Oh, yeah. I like that. What is that?
That's the music that
go play some more. Yeah. It kind of reminds me of Eye of the Tiger. Rising up, back on the street. Hit my time, hit my tono. Rhyming Vancouver's in the time of his beat. And the flutesy is getting drunk. It's the eye of the pepper. It's the thrill of the light. And we all go to Queens in our own bros. It's the eye of the pepper. It's the thrill of the fight. And we have a tuna can cock. Eye of the pepper. Come on. Come on, rock. Come on, jab. Uppercut. Left, right. Punch. Boom. Yeah, that sounds good. Eye of the pepper. I have the pepper live. That's hot. That's sizzling, baby. You got it. You turned me on, baby. I tell you, there's a reason why guitarists get laid, huh? Sean L. Barry?
Apparently you get
turned on. I'm ready to fucking make out with him. I mean, who gets... Roy, you play all these humongous, gigantic festivals in Europe.
Yeah.
Who gets more action, the guitarist or the Roy Schaefer, the keyboardist?
I'll go with the guitarist.
Really? Yeah. That's a sexier instrument?
Much sexier.
Keyboardist or drummer?
I'm going to go with the drummer.
Oh, right. All right.
Yeah, keys are last.
I'm going to do Roy against yourself. Keyboardist versus accordionist.
I don't have a chance in hell. I'm going to go with the keyboardist.
All right. I would do that too. Because keyboardist, you can still do well, someone's got to be a sex symbol who plays keyboard, right, Pepper? Who? Rick Wakeman. Do you know him?
I know who he is. Yeah, I don't think he's a sex symbol.
Apparently,
the guy wears capes. I don't know how much of a sex symbol he's going to be.
Hold on, time out. Pepper said Paige McConnell. He is the ugliest member of Fish by a long country mile.
Yeah,
long country mile. Yeah, even even Mike Gordon's like, Bruce, ew. Paige McConnell. I better get fucking more ass than Paige McConnell.
Yeah. Bruce Hornsby, huh?
Oh, yeah, Bruce Hornsby got a lot of shit done, right? Yeah. All right.
I think the guy from Faith No More is gay, so he probably gets
a lot it on here. I swear it's on a nightstand. Oh, I love Faith No More. Yeah. I'll give it on here. I give it on a nightstand. Yeah. The soul of secret. And I could keep my mind up. What pooping, pump the ball, yeah. What pooping, what? Oh, whatever.
What?
That was a small victory by Faith No More, as interpreted by the Dave Man. Ryan, you seem to be a big Faith No More guy. Faith No More, he loves it. He confirmed it, and he said he loves Angel Dust,
Mike
too.
Mike Patton,
that's the name of the album.
Crazy bastard.
Yeah, I didn't want that nugget to slip underneath the radar, but he did confess to liking Angel Dust, Pepper. Maybe you and him have something to talk about after the show.
Let's smoke some Angel Dust.
Maybe you can pick up a package from Vancouver if you're ever up north. You know what I mean? Do you take a lot of trips to Canada?
I've been to Montreal once.
I've been to Montreal once. I'm trying
fun.
To think. I don't believe I've been anywhere else. I've been to Montreal one time, and I was only 11, but I got gacked out of my fucking skull, man.
Nice.
And I called up my friend who was a football coach. I go, hey, Coach Sandusky, get your ass up here now. Let's get some charity work done, dude. Second mile, yo.
Oh, Jesus.
Well, that's why I have a lot of problems. Unresolved. That's what my therapist says. Unresolved. That's what they call me. They call me the unresolved master.
Nonstop child molester.
Go ahead, unresolved master.
Unresolved master! Unresolved master! He's the one that we all resolve after!
I thought you were going to, like, he has issues after, or something like that.
I thought you were just going to fizzle out, like, just completely unresolved.
Oh, that would be good. See, Sean O'Barry knows. Okay. Sean O, 8,000 points for you. Innocentius, please add that to the Sean O pile of points. Minus 200 for Pepper.
Why?
Minus 200.
The fuck?
Dave Richter,
yes, sir.
Put yourself on the ledger today. You've done a great job. 12 points for you, baby.
Thank you. 12. Fucking scorching. Makes no sense.
Minus 80 for you, Pepper, since you're complaining again.
This is bullshit, dude.
Flutesy, you're in Pepperland. Minus 300 for you.
But I haven't spoke the whole time.
Minus fucking 300! Don't fuck with me, Flutesy! I fucking said it before the goddamn show! Actually, Flutesy, did you learn that Braveheart song? You and Roy outlawed pipes on outlawed things?
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
Go ahead. Roy Schaefer and Flutesy have put together the Braveheart song because Charno is going to the Red Hot Chili Pipers on Sunday. So they decided to tribute Charno Barry. Here's the song from Braveheart as interpreted by Roy and Flutesy. Go ahead. Go ahead, guys. And I'm curious myself to see how this happens because you guys didn't rehearse it at all.
So excited.
Theme to Braveheart. Here we go. Theme to Braveheart.
Close.
Is this a They Might Be Giant song?
I think I hear it.
All right, hold on. Flutesy's got something. Flutesy's closer than Roy. Actually, I like your guitar, Dave Richter. It's got a U2 sound to it. Well, it was 1968, and we were trying to get back the North and South together. We had a freedom walk. But blood was shed on one red Sunday. Hence the song, Sunday Bloody Sunday. I have run highest mountains. I have gone through the fields only to be with you. Only to be with you. I have run, I have crawled, I have scaled these city walls, these city walls, only to be with
but I still haven't found what I'm looking for.
You two dragged in mud.
But I still haven't found what I'm looking for.
I'm liking it.
I believe in the kingdom come. Fill all the colors and bleed into one. Bleed into one. Yes, I'm still running. You broke the bones and you loose the chain. Carry the bone.
Money, I want you two and Bob Dylan. I would give Ray Wiley a video, but I mean, just go see actual Ray Wiley video.
He was actually here
on our YouTube channel.
We covered a cover of ourselves.
Just put in Davey Mac Sports Program and Ray Wiley Hubbard for the actual Ray Wiley stuff. He's been here twice, I believe, right? Or three times?
Two times.
Yeah. When's he coming in town again?
Really? I gotta call him.
We gotta get him back. I love that man.
All right, I will.
He's fucking great.
He's got a new album out.
New album. Let's plug that.
I don't know the name of it.
All right. Great plug.
Weird name for an album.
I don't know the name. Ray Wiley's new triple disc album. I don't know the name. Get on your iTunes immediately. As for myself, my name is Eastside Dave, the Davey Mac, and the Chris Pepper Stanley.
What's up?
And the Sean O'Barry. The Roy Shaver.
Good night.
The Dave Richter. And Floatsy. And Ryan from Vancouver. And Eric Zane. Good.